Welcome to this MiniSwap demo. MiniSwap is a decentralized application that runs from your Minima node and enables you to do cross-chain swaps peer-to-peer between the Minima and Ethereum blockchains. You can swap native Minima to or from ETH or ERC20, USDC, USDT or wrapped Minima. You will need to find a counterparty with the opposite interest to yours and agree a price via a chat, and then you can enter into a swap together. How does the contract work? MiniSwap uses a hash time lock contract which lasts 12 hours, approximately, starting from when the native Minima seller locks their coins. The Ethereum asset seller then has 4 hours to lock their funds. If they fail to do so, the swap will be invalid and the native Minima seller will be able to get a refund at the end of the 12 hours. Once the ETH user has locked up, the native Minima seller will have 4 hours to claim the Ethereum asset. If they fail to claim within that time frame, the ETH user will be able to get a refund. When the native Minima seller claims the ETH, a secret is revealed on chain that allows the user selling the ETH asset to claim the native Minima. It's very important that the ETH user claims the native Minima before the end of the contract. Once the contract expires, the native Minima seller can collect their coins on chain even if they have already collected the ETH. In this demo, the contract length has been set to 30 minutes, so the time shown here will differ to yours. So let's start. Both users will need to be running a Minima node and have MetaMask installed on their browser. You will also need some Ethereum to pay for gas fees. If you're an Android node runner, you'll need to connect to your MiniDApp hub using the desktop connect feature. You can find the URL and password that you need to log in from the help page in the app. And your phone must be connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your desktop. So in this demo, I have two Minima nodes running and two MetaMask wallets. Here you can see I already have MiniSwap installed and connected. And on this node, I'm going to show you how to install MiniSwap if you haven't installed a MiniDApp to your node before. So you should only download MiniDApps from the official MiniDApp store, minidapps.minima.global, and once MiniSwap is released, you'll be able to download it from here. You can also get it from the DApp store in the Android app. Once you've downloaded it from the MiniDApp hub, scroll to the bottom and select the MiniDApp you've just downloaded. Once that's installed, go back to the main page and scroll down to find it. All MiniDApps are installed with read access by default. This means that they can't run commands that access your wallet without triggering a pending action which needs to be accepted. MiniSwap does need write access, so you will need to set it by clicking on the write button and then select OK. Now you can see the permissions have changed from read to write. The first time you open MiniSwap, please take some time to read through the risks and understand those risks. Your node must be in sync with the top block before you start a swap. So also check that your counterparty has the same top block as you do. You can see your block and time at the bottom here. You must not delete MiniSwap before a swap is complete, as the MiniDApp contains information that you need to be able to complete the swap successfully. If you're swapping your native Minima and your counterparty does not lock up their funds within 4 hours, you'll be able to get a refund at the end of the contract, which is approximately 12 hours. When you're swapping Ethereum or ERC20 tokens, you must lock up your funds and share the receipt within those 4 hours after the native Minima user has locked theirs. When swapping ERC20 tokens, if your transaction is delayed because the gas fee is too low, you must know how to resubmit it with a higher gas fee. And when swapping ERC20 tokens, you must claim the native Minima before the contract expires. Once you've found somebody to trade with, select I have already found a counterparty. So on the left side here, this is going to be the user who is selling their Ethereum assets. And on the right, this is going to be the user selling their native Minima and collecting the Ethereum asset. So the user selling native Minima starts the process by clicking on Minima for tokens. And let's do a swap between Minima and wrapped Minima. So here the user is going to sell 0.008 for the same wrapped Minima, just doing small amounts here. Now you need the counterparty's public key. So they start their side of the process by selecting I want to swap tokens for Minima, and they copy their public key and share it with the counterparty. Review the swap and click continue to lock the native Minima on chain. Once those funds have been successfully locked, you'll get a receipt that you have to share with your counterparty. They will then have to wait for this to be confirmed on chain. Once that's confirmed on chain, the user will be able to review the swap. At this point, they'll need to do two transactions, one to approve the spend of wrapped Minima in this case. So you will need to put in a spending cap, and you can set it to max, or you can set a custom spending cap as long as it's above the amount that you're swapping. Once that's gone through, you need to lock the funds. Once the Ethereum asset, in this case wrapped Minima, has been locked up, they'll get a receipt that they again need to share with their counterparty, which will allow them to claim the wrapped Minima. This user will also need to do an Ethereum transaction to withdraw from the smart contract. Now that's gone through, you can view the transaction on Etherscan. And note that you might not see the amount shown in your MetaMask wallet. So you can see the withdrawal from the contract, and to see the amount, you can click on it and view that in the Block Explorer. This now allows the other user to claim the native Minima. So they click on Claim Minima, and the swap is now complete. Next, I'll show you an example of a refund. In this example, I'll show you an example of two users who have both locked up, but neither of them have claimed, and so they can both get a refund. So from the pending swaps tab, you'll see any swaps that have not been completed yet. And here you can see that it has expired. So this user was selling 0.08 ETH for 0.1 Minima, and this user was on the other side of that trade. So this is now expired, so the ETH user is able to get a refund. You'll need to again do a transaction to withdraw from the smart contract. And once that's gone through, you will see the refund in your MetaMask. And again, you can click on that and view that on the Block Explorer to see the refund go through. The other user is then able to claim the minima back. And once they return to pending swaps, you'll see any swaps that have been completed and refunded. At any point in the process, you can come back to how to swap to review the steps involved. Thank you for watching this MiniSwap demo. We hope you enjoy trading peer-to-peer.